Hi viewers, the experiment is junction diode or PN junction diode. This is very simple experiment. Observe here, and this is the reason holes are majority carriers. So this is called P region. Here electrons are majority carriers. This is called EN. So adding these two, this one is called PN junction diode. Okay, if the P region or P side is connected to positive terminal of the battery, N is connected to negative terminal of the battery, that means P to P, N to N, the diode is in forward bias. In the reverse order, P is connected to negative terminal, N is connected to positive terminal, the diode is in reverse bias. This is the circuit diagram using in our experiment. This is diode. Here arrow mark indicates P side, bar line indicates N side. Between these two terminals we connect a voltmeter. Positive terminal is connected to negative terminal of ammeter. Positive to resistance box, rheostat to battery. But in our colleges, in our experiments, we use directly a kit. Now I will explain and I will introduce how to take the readings, how to give the connections in the kit. Okay students, this is the kit we are using to find VI characteristics using PN junction diode. Observe here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 terminals. These two we are using in forward bias. These two we are using in the reverse bias. First we learn how to connect junction diode in forward bias. This is very simple experiment. Observe clearly in this kit. First connect, this is milliammeter or micrometer. The positive terminal of the milliammeter or micrometer is connected to positive terminal of the voltmeter. Okay, one connection is over, that means from this end to this end. Next we connect crossly, that means negative terminal of the milliammeter or micrometer is connected to positive side of the diode. In the same manner, negative terminal of the voltmeter is connected to negative side of the diode. Okay, now our connections are over. Here we use only three wires. One is end to end, another one is we connect crossly from here to here, next another one we connect crossly from here to here. Now I introduce voltmeter and milliammeter, how to take the readings. Okay, observe here carefully. In forward bias we use this downward scale, in reverse bias we use this upward scale. This is the voltmeter. It starts from 0 to 1. The 10th line is 0.2, that means every line is equal to 0.02 volts. So 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1. Observe upward scale. This is 0 to 50. 10 lines equal to 10. So each line equal to 1 volt. Okay. In forward bias we use this downward scale, in reverse bias we use this upward scale. Next we learn how to use ammeter. Observe here, this is micrometer or milliammeter. The above readings are micrometer readings. We are using this in the reverse bias. The below readings are milliammeter readings. We are using this in forward bias. The downward scale is 0, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. That means 10 lines equal to 3. That means every line equal to 0.3. okay, 0.3, 0.6, 0.9, like that it increases up to 3. Next, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Observe here, the upward scale is 0, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. This is in microamps, this is in milliamps. Okay, now we learn how to do the experiment, that means how to take the readings. Observe here, this is the rheostat. We use this one in the forward bias. This is another rheostat or coil. We use this knob in the reverse bias. Okay, observe here, here is one knob. This side, this is reverse bias, this is forward bias. If the diode is in forward bias, we move this knob to this side. Here also one knob is there. This also, if we pull this side, this is reverse bias, this is forward bias. In forward bias, pull it in the in this direction. Okay, now the diode is completely in forward bias. We will start the experiment. Observe here. Okay, first set the voltage at 0.1. okay, the voltage is 0.1. Observe in milliammeter, it shows 0. So there is no current flows in the circuit for 0.1. Note the readings carefully. In forward bias, if the voltage is 0.1, current is 0. Next, increase the voltage. So now it is at 2. That means 0.2. Observe here, the micrometer shows same 0 reading. For 0.2 volts, current is 0. Next, increase to 0.3. Okay, now the voltage is 0.3. Same, it shows 0 reading. Current is 0 for 0.10, 0.20, 0.30. Increase the voltage to 0.4. Okay, now the voltage is at 0.4. Yes, it shows some current. Observe clearly. It is at second division. Every division equal to 0.3. Second one means 0.6. So if voltage is 0.4, current is 0.6 milliamps. In the same way, increase. Now it is at 0.5. The current is at ninth line. 9 means 9.3 is a 27. That means 2.7 volts. At 0.5, the current reading is 2.7 milliamps. Next, again increase voltage. So this is at 0.6. Observe current. It is 6, middle one is 7.8. So 0.6, 7.8. Now the current rises rapidly. Next, increase to 0.7. So current is last one 15, last one, but one equal to 14.4. okay, 0.7, 14.4. next, again increase 0.1. so now the voltage is at 0.8. it crosses the 15. okay, now for 0.7, right, this is 15. Stop the experiment. Now the forward bias is completed. Next, we will conduct the experiment in reverse bias. Okay. Now we connect the diode is in reverse biased. Observe here, just half the machine and pull it. It fix the upwards. Here also same. It fix the upwards. Now the diode is in reverse biased. Next, pull the knob in this direction. This is also this direction. So this is in reverse bias, this is in reverse bias. We use this rheostat to change the readings. Okay, no? In forward bias, we use this one. In reverse bias, we use this one. Now, we start the experiment. Okay. Here we use upward scale. It is 0 to 50. Start the experiment from 2 volts. So now the voltmeter shows 2 volts. Observe ammeter. Ammeter shows some reading. Here also we use upwards. This is 0, 20, 40, like that. So first one is 2. Okay. So it shows 2 micro amperes. Note the reading for 2 volts. Current is 2 micro amperes. Next, increase another one. Now this is at 4. This is at second line. Second line means 4 volts. So for 4 micrometers. Next increase it 6. This is at same second one, 4 micro amps. Okay, in the same way, take the readings up to 10. Next, we draw the graph between voltage and current in forward bias and reverse bias. Okay, hi students, these are the readings came in our experiments. Observe here, this is forward voltage, forward current. If forward voltage is 0, current also 0, 0.1, 0, 0.2, 0, 0.3, 0. At 0.4, the forward current is 0.6. Next, for every time 0.1 voltage increases, current increases rapidly. Here, on x-axis, forward voltage is taken, on y-axis, forward current is taken. For 0.1, 0. For 0.2, 0. For 0.3, 0. 0.4, 0.6. 0.5, 2.7. 0.6, 0.6, 7.8. 0.7, 14.4. For 0.8, is greater than 15. So, it rises like that. If voltage increases, current also increases. But in reverse bias, the current is in micro amps. The voltage increases from 0 to 1. Current increases in micro amps 0 to 4. So for 0, 0. For 1, this is 4. For 2, this is 6. For 3, this is 12. For 4, this is 16. For 5, 20. Like this, it increases. After one value, it increases suddenly. This voltage is called breakdown voltage. So this is the VI characteristics graph. This is the very simple experiment. In this experiment, there is no calculations. Only for voltage, we determine current. in forward bias and reverse bias. Using that values, we drawn a graph. Okay, now the experiment is completed. If you like this video, like it, share to your friends. Subscribe to Vishnu channel. Thank you.